If the gap had been strongly defended by the aggressor, coordinated use of heavier fire support would have been required. In just about 3 minutes, the bridge is launched and cleared for the march column. As soon as the assault force has crossed, the AVLB proceeds to the far side to retrieve the launched bridge, an operation that takes from 10 minutes to an hour, depending on soil conditions at the site. Here's another use for the armored vehicle launched bridge. When a bridge is unsafe for the weight of armored vehicles, or when it has been partially destroyed, the launched bridge provides the needed reinforcement. This Class 30 bridge is now capable of supporting heavy divisional loads. The AVLB is also useful for bridging swampy places and sinkholes in the line of march. Armor movements across marshy shores have always been a problem, sometimes requiring construction of corduroy roads under enemy fire. The AVLB bridges the gap between firm ground and water without delay or exposure of personnel. Railroad cuts, canals, and many other short barriers found in a combat zone can be bridged in the ways we have shown. The height, width, and overhang of the folded bridge presents a problem which must be handled carefully in passing through towns or villages. When the loaded vehicle is too high for an underpass, the bridge may be launched and pushed through on the roadbed. The bridge can be launched and recovered on uphill grades of 28%. On downhill grades of 19%. And on transverse grades of 11%. When emplacing the bridge, it is important to have a firm bearing at each end. The minimum bearing at either end is 1.5 feet. This gives a maximum 60-foot clear span for the 63-foot bridge, with a normal rating of class 60, a caution rating of class 65, and a risk rating of class 75. With a roadway width of 12.5 feet, the launched bridge can carry both tracked and wheeled vehicles, straddling the undecked center section. Vehicles wider than 12.5 feet can cross the bridge when the curbs are removed. Each treadway is wide enough to accommodate a quarter-ton truck. Filler sections provide a flush deck for non-assault use. These sections are a safety factor when the bridge is slippery from mud and snow. Emergency spanning of short gaps on main supply routes is one of the many uses for this equipment. In the event it is necessary to leave the bridge behind for use of following units, a replacement bridge may be assembled from components brought forward on two bridge cargo trucks. For this contingency, three extra bridges are provided for the six AVLBs organic to the Engineer Battalion of the Armored Division. The Infantry Division Engineer Battalion also has three extra bridges in addition to its three complete AVLBs. To save time, replacement bridges may be fully assembled in rear areas and brought forward in a folded position on a bridge transporting trailer or a semi-trailer, organic to engineer units. A launcher can load it as quickly as it can retrieve the bridge it has left in place. In addition to the mobile AVLB, other types of assault bridges are available. This is the basic component of the mobile floating assault bridge, originally developed by the French Army. Highly mobile, it is capable of traveling on land and water, powered by its 225 horsepower diesel engine. The ramp unit is a carrier vehicle used to deliver and connect its ramp section to the bridge unit. After the ramp unit has been aligned with the bridge unit, connection is made by hydraulically operated pins. The ramp is then lifted off the carrier unit, freeing it for subsequent operations. Units can be assembled at a rate of more than 400 feet per hour into a bridge capable of carrying the heaviest army loads. Another type of assault bridging used to assist armor movement is the M4T6 fixed span bridge, organic to the Armored Engineer Battalion. This bridge can be constructed in 30 minutes or less by an Armored Engineer platoon. Use of helicopters to fly in components and partially assembled sections will decrease construction time and exposure time of personnel. The maximum unsupported span that will carry the armored division load is 38 feet 4 inches. When intermediate supports are used, wider gaps can be bridged. 9 38-foot fixed bridges can be constructed from the M4T6 bridging equipment, organic to the bridge company of the Armored Division Engineer Battalion. Here's an expedient, the V-folded M4 balk bridge, which is constructed of standard balk and hinged in the middle. The near end of the bridge is supported on the launching vehicle. The far end is supported by carrying cable or chain, formed into a free-running loop to allow the bridge to unfold easily when lowered. The cable is fastened to a quick-release device. After the bridge is lowered to the far bank, the launching vehicle backs up, permitting the near end to drop. As the cable is played out, the weight of the decking causes it to unfold. Then the cable is released. The bridge is now ready for traffic. To summarize, the armored vehicle launched bridge, used primarily in assault crossings, is a girder type bridge weighing 14 tons, capable of bridging 60-foot gaps. It is carried, launched and retrieved by a modified tank chassis specially equipped with hydraulic power and apparatus. A two-man crew operate the launching equipment, drive the vehicle, and maintain all important radio contact. It is highly mobile, capable of keeping up with fast-moving armor operations. Without weapons of its own, it is protected by other armored vehicles. The bridge can be launched and cleared in 3 minutes without exposing the crew to enemy fire. It can be used to bridge obstacles of many types, such as marshy shorelines, and to reinforce or replace weak or damaged bridges. For smaller gaps, M4T6 bridge components can be used to assist armor movement. Expedient bridges can be fabricated when standard assault bridging is not available. These, then, are some of the characteristic types and uses of assault bridging, an extremely effective aid in keeping assault forces moving to maintain the momentum of the attack.